Welcome to this Carbon Mods video tutorial on basic carbon fibre lamination. The aim of this tutorial is to give you some simple, practical, easy to follow advice on how you can make good quality carbon fibre parts at home using our kit. First, let's take a quick look at what you actually get in the kit. You get a roll of carbon fibre cloth, 1 metre by 30 centimetres. You get a roll of glass, woven glass cloth, exactly the same size. You get some specifically developed carbon fibre laminating resin. Two parts, resin and a hardener. You get PVA mould release agent, which allows the part to be pulled from the mould, you'll see this later. You also get two mixing sticks and cups, 1 inch laminating brush, a couple of pairs of latex gloves. Other things you'll need, reasonably accurate set scales, either a heat gun or a hairdryer, some good quality scissors, some lint-free cloth, either tissue, cloth, both fine, and whatever you're going to be using as your mold.
Right, so to get started on the part, we'll be applying the release agent first onto the mold. So buff on your latex gloves that you got in the kit, and apply your PVA release agent thoroughly onto a piece of tissue or cloth, anything that won't drop fibre onto the mould. What you're looking to do is get a good even coat all over your mould, really focusing on the corners and any gaps. Basically, this is acting as a barrier between your resin and your mould, stopping it from sticking. Once you've coated it really thoroughly and evenly, you want to give it a quick check over and check and leave it for approximately 20 minutes or so until it's touch dry on the surface. Right, so now I'll be mixing up the resin. The resin is mixed at a 2-to-1 ratio, so if you take, say, 100 grams of the resin, you'll mix that with 50 grams of the hardener. Do it as accurately as you can, to within 1 or 2% is ideal, and that'll ensure that your part cures properly and thoroughly. Make sure you mix it really well, get it all from the edges of the cup. Spend a good bit of time doing it. So now we'll get the surface coat of epoxy down onto the mould. Basically, what you're looking to do is apply a nice, thin, but very even coat of the resin onto the mould. What you'll then be doing is leaving it for 2 or 3 hours until it's gone to a state of tacky hardness. Basically, that means when you press your thumb onto it, it'll leave a fingerprint, but it won't come off on your finger. So now we're getting onto the more interesting part. We're actually dealing with the carbon fibre reinforcement itself. Here you can see we're just cutting out the material. Great little trick that you've seen there is pulling out the strand. It gives you a nice straight line to cut so your fibres don't fray. What you want is to cut your material a little bit bigger than the area of the final part. That way you've got a good overlap over the top. When you put the carbon down, you want to make sure there's no loose strands of carbon under there, because they'll be on the surface of your part. You want to lay the carbon down really, really gently and evenly, because you're dealing with a tacky surface, so it is going to want to stick. So as soon as you pressed it, it's pretty much down for good. So working from the middle of the part outwards, keeping the edges lifted up if needs be to stop them sticking to the corners of the mould, work around the edge, pressing it onto the surface of your semi-cured resin all the way over, working all the sharp corners. Basically, the straighter and neater you do this, the better your final part will look. It is the most critical part of the entire process by a long stage if you want cosmetically pleasing parts. So now you will mix up another batch of resin like we did earlier, and we're going to start actually applying the resin onto the mould. What you want to use is a stippling action. If you drag your brush across the surface, you'll pull the weave, distort the weave, and you'll end up with a messy looking part. So very carefully, imagine you're just pressing the resin into the reinforcement. Just a reasonable amount. First few layers, you can be quite liberal. And this is another fantastic little trick. It gets rid of all the small air bubbles. What you do, use your hairdryer or your heat gun, blow over the surface of the mould, and you'll actually see the surface sort of just little bubbles popping. You don't want to get it too hot though, and you'll just feel that the resin gets a lot thinner. And then for any of the complex areas, just use your finger, really press in nice and hard on any tight radiuses, any areas that you think the carbon, there could be air voids underneath, sort of use your finger as a squeegee. You can actually use squeegees or little rubber scrapers if you wanted to, but for smaller parts you really don't need to. Your fingers will do the job. So now we're going to get on, lay subsequent layers of reinforcement down. You can do these a fair bit quicker than your last layers, but it's exactly the same process. Drop them down and then squeegee through with your brush, making sure you've got a nice even amount of resin, but you don't want it sloshing about there. It should just be to the point where the fibres are wetted out, but not, there's no sort of free resin standing on the surface. You shouldn't see anything running around or washing about in there. It's really just dampening the fibres consistently, so there's no air, but by the same respect you've not got too much resin. The less resin you use, the stronger the part will actually be, because you've got a higher ratio of fibre to resin. When you're finishing up the last stages of the part, just go around, trim off the excess. That stops the fibre draping down and lifting off the resin while it lifts off the reinforcement while it's curing. Just go around the edges and then do a final good check, pressing in all the corners, making sure that any sharp negative corners are materials really worked into before you set it on one side. You almost can't do this for too long. You've got a good long time on your mould. Once you're happy, set it on one side and leave it to cure, which could easily take, a full day, good thing, leave it overnight, and then you come back to it in the morning, it'll be ready to crack out.